Shibava so Shepherd
Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome.
In Jesus Christ's name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Those of us who are not in our country, we are in other countries. I believe many of us want to have residents of that country, man.
Amen.
1 year or 2 years or 3 years, we want permanent residence. I mean a passport. Say, Father, bless me in the country that I am. Give me legality, legalize me, give me that which will make me to be what you want to be in that country that I am now. In the name of Jesus Christ, open up our prayers.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, my Father, my God,
Lord,
I beg you in the name of you, Father, bless me in this country. Jesus, bless me in this country, Lord. Make my feet to stand in this country, Lord. Everything that will make me, Lord, Father, do it for me. Father, establish me, establish my husband, and my children in this country, Lord. Father, what we are praying for you, Father, grant it unto us, O Lord. Father, I beg you, O Lord, Father, let me possess the protection of this land in the name of Jesus. As I stand, I want to live in this country to glorify you.
Amen.
As we are prayed, so shall it be in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Father, we thank you, we bless you, worship you, we exalt your name. Yeah. And most high, we thank you because you are a good God and a wonderful Father. Lord Jesus, we have come to hear from you again. Father, speak, O God, for your children are ready to hear. Father, I have no word of my own. Father, talk to me and talk through me. My body, soul, spirit, tongue, everything belongs to you. Use it, O God, to your glory, to the end that we all will be blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Father, because I know Satan have been expelled already, and all his demons have been expelled in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, our message this hour is titled Illegal but Permanent Residence. Illegal but Permanent Residence. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Illegal. But he's there. Not just there, having permanent residence. There are countries you will go, if you enter there illegally, the country, they will arrest you and deport you out of the country. Because you are illegal. But if a country you enter, they will absorb you as an illegal resident. They will give you passports in that country. Who want to be there?
Amen. I want to be there in Jesus' name.
God forbid.
In Jesus' name.
God forbid. God forbid. Don't be here. Use wisdom. Sorry. Mm-hmm. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
There is a country we enter illegally. They'll welcome you and give you permanent residence there. you come to Germany illegally and they catch you, they will deport you back to where you came from. But the country you will get to, there's no deportation. Every illegal occupant there will stay there forever. That place called Hellfire. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Every soul in hell are illegal. Because hell was never made for human beings. Children of God, this is my message this morning. Every soul in hellfire are not meant to be there. Hellfire was never meant for the children of God. They are illegal in hell, but they are being given permanent residence. So I'm here to announce to you that you must not go there. If you get in there because of one sin or the other, the devil will tell you you were not supposed to be here. The first thing the demons will tell you they have, what are you doing here? You were not supposed to be here. And the next thing they will do, they will issue you a passport, permanent resident of hell. And there you will be forever. The only country I know that deportation is prohibited. In hellfire, deportation is what? Prohibited. There's no plane that come out of that place. There is no airport that flight plane out of that place. It's a country, a very big country. And as we are talking right now, there are billions, not millions, billions and trillions of residents there. And all of them are illegal. And there's nothing you can do about it. So I'm afraid, sir, so that I will not be an occupant there. And I pray none of us will go to that country in the name of Jesus Christ.
Oh,
amen. The Bible told us, a king is coming who will ask us a question. What will be that question? The king will ask us, first of all, he will praise you. Hey, my daughter, you have done well. My son, you have done well. You have removed everything you need to remove. Your body is glittering. You have taken away everything that the Bible says you take away, but something is missing. And this is what I'm here to talk to you about now, this morning. After you have done all this well, after you say, Angel Gabriel, Angel Michael, do you see this woman? When she was on earth, she did everything that eyes could see. But something is missing. And if it's missing in my life, in your life, we have to start doing it now before the time comes. The Bible told us in Matthew chapter 25, the Bible says in verse 33, and he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goat on the left. And then shall the king say unto them on the right hand, come ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. 35. For I was hunger, and you gave me meat. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was stranger, and you took me in. Naked, you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came unto me. Then shall the righteous answer him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee a hunger and fed thee, or thirsty and gave them drink, when saw we thee a stranger and took thee in, or naked and clothed thee, or when saw we thee sick or in prison and came unto thee. And the king, which is Jesus Christ, shall answer and say unto them, verily I say unto you, inasmuch as you have done it unto one of the least of these my brethren, you have done it unto me. Verse 41. Then shall he say also unto them that are the left hand, depart from me, ye cast into everlasting fire, not prepared for you. Depart from me, you cast into everlasting fire, not prepared for you. I paraphrase, prepare for the devil and his angels. You are going there, but it was never for you. You will be illegal there, my son. You'll be illegal there, my daughter, but there you will be forever. A permanent resident permit will be issued you, though it's not a place you were supposed to be. Though I never made that place for you, but there you shall be forever. Why? Because of little €1 you would have given to somebody. Because of your stinginess. Because of your hard-heartedness. Because of I, me, and I alone. Because of your bad mind. You will enter into a place that will never make for you. After you have removed your earring very well. After you have done all this well. But because of your prognosis. Because of your erudite. Because of your super glue hand. Because of you don't know what to do when somebody is in pain. Because you have refused to do what you're supposed to do. Somebody came to you and tell you, I am hungry. You tell the person, okay, let me pray for you. And the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. And you have money in your pocket to give the person to eat. You will go to hell and remain in hell forever. But it was never meant for you. Man of God, I am hungry, sir. You are hungry? Just I am hungry. What does it take to quench hunger? Just €1, a loaf of bread can quench hunger. But you tell the person, let me pray for you. The Bible says such man of God is liable to go to hell. Your friend is languishing in pain. You have a lot on you. But then your friend will come to you and tell you, my sister, look at what I'm going through. You might even peck the sister. And after the sister has gone, you will carry your phone. Okay, man. So, sister, just came to me now. He's suffering. I thought he have come to me now. I thought she would not come. You will go to hell. You just mock your friend. The Lord is warning you. You that is mocking people who are coming to you for help. You cannot help them. You call them to yourself as if you want to help them. Just to get waste from them. And carry forth and start mocking them. You are mocking your soul. You will go to hell. The Lord says, I warn you. I don't know who you are right now on this mountain. You are specialized in mocking people. You are specialized in mocking your friends. Because God has given you opportunity to be what you think you are. It's only opportunity. You are not better than that person anyway. That your friend, you are mocking. That person you are laughing at. You are not better than that person. Intelligence is better than you. In wisdom is better than you. In holiness is better than you. Just that you have opportunity to be where you are now. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. So be careful when God gives you opportunity to do what He has sent to do. The Bible said to us in verse 42, for I was hunger, you never fed me. I was a stranger, you never care about me. Then shall they answer, when were you hungry? I'm paraphrasing. When were you hungry? Lord Jesus, I was always praising you. I was always doing this. I never saw you hunger. But you saw me one day. I came to you one day. And I told you I was hungry. Say, ow! But I never saw you. And they'll put the picture for you. They will show you the film there. Do you know this woman? Hey, I know this woman. Do you know this boy? This child, I know him. You remember so time he came to you? Sir, I remember. So what did you do? As far as This child never desired to eat from you. You don't also desire to eat the fruit of life in my kingdom. As far as this person never desired to wear the clothes from you, you don't desire to wear the clothes in my kingdom. And many Christians today, they are missing it. Many of you on this mountain right now, listen to me. You are missing it. Why? Because of your stinginess. Why? Because I, my husband, and my wife alone. You don't care to know if others are suffering. Look at churches everywhere. You don't care about their members. You don't care about the poor. As far as the minister and the welfare children are living well, every other person can go to hell. That hell is waiting for them. If Apostle Emmanuel is visiting, it's also waiting for me if I don't repent now. How do you think about other people? Somebody will call you, you have the money with you. Somebody will beg you, my brother, my sister, my children are in pain. We have no place to stay. The first thing we do, look at your children. I'm not here to quote and quote Bible. I'll be quoting Bible verses. You are not hearing. Look at your children. As that woman is talking, I'm not bragging here. I remember 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago, a woman called me from Nigeria. Said, my son just got an admission into university. And there's no money. So you are here, sir. There's no money. The first thing that entered my mind, if somewhere I've got admission now, and I have the money, what will I do? Will I say no? I remember what my uncle did to me when I got admission into university. Because of I had admission, the wife had to say, okay, now wash my clothes for me. Because they know if I refuse, that school fees, they will not pay for me. I remember all this. Woman, how much is the money? 200,000 naira. What do I do? I added 50,000 to make it 250,000 naira. So you are here. I'm not saying this to pray myself. I'm saying it for you to learn. I'm supposed to say, learn from me. Know that I have it in abundance. Know that it's surplus. Bro, Fred is here. He will bear witness. The few times we have met together, he knows what we have done together. That is how life should be. That is how it should be. Let us put people in our shoe. You have 1,000 arrows with you. Your people are languishing in Nigeria, wherever you come from. Your in-laws are languishing. Your parents are languishing. But because you have opportunity to be in Ireland in January, wherever you think you are, you think you will never, I have said to the lady, I will never be deported. You use your mind to look at, I have residence, my children have, I have the worst of all they will do. I will never suffer again. You will suffer. You will suffer. I will never go to Africa to ever beg there for life. I am settled for life. You are not settled anything. If sickness hold you, you will go to Africa. Praise Master Jesus. Just a little touch. Those people you have neglected, you will run to them one day. I'm telling you this. I'm not here to quote Bible scripture. Let's use conscience today. I am angry. My spirit is angry because of the life Christians are living today. My soul is bleeding. He did the life Christ lived when he was on earth. Christ was a giver. He gave and gave and gave to the end. He gave his life for us. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. The Lord is expected to also give our only shirt for somebody to wear.
The Lord is only also expecting you to give them 1 euro that you have for somebody to eat and see if God will not provide for you. You have one car, you are looking for another car. You have 2 cars, you are looking for it. Let us be wise. Hell is waiting. Oh, ye man of God, hell is waiting for you. Oh, ye woman, hell is waiting for you if we don't repent today. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible told us in Romans chapter 2. In Romans chapter 2, verse 3. And take thou this, O man, that judge them. We do so things, and do it the same, that thou should escape the judgment of God. I come again. And take thou this, O man, that judge them. We do so things, and do the same, that thou should escape the judgment of God. No, you are preaching a love your neighbor as yourself, but your heart is deep. You have sugar-coated mouth to preach love. The Bible says love, and the only people you love is your wife and your children. If you are members in your church, you don't love them. Praise Master Jesus. Verse 4. Oh, despite all the riches of his goodness and forbearance and long-suffering, not knowing that the goodness of God leadeth thee to repentance. Verse 5. But after the hardiness and impenitence of heart, treasure of untold thyself, wrath against that day, against the day of wrath, and revelation of the righteous judgment of God. The Lord shall judge us righteously. We all shall be judged righteously. Be mounting up your iniquity. You are happy. Everybody under you are suffering. All my friends are suffering. I am better than them. No problem. You look at every other woman in Ireland. You are better than every other person. In your family, you are better than you are. Be careful. Be careful. In my family, I am the best. I am the richest. Among all my friends, I am the best. Nobody can wear the shoe I'm wearing. If you die, that shoe, they will hit to your head. Those things you are used to boast now. If you die, they will pack it up for you and burn you with them. Your head fire will start on earth here. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Verse 6. Who will render to every man according to his deed. According to his deed, the Lord will judge me according to my deed. If I'm preaching, I'm not doing it. If not, they will ask me. And if I'm preaching, you are not doing it. If not, they will ask you. He that will ask us is coming. There's a soul that says, our rewarder is coming. He will reward you according to your work. It's not by saying it, it's by doing it. Praise Master Jesus. You are afraid of hell. You are removed here and up. You are not afraid of hell. That one is one part of it. As my sister will always say, said, holiness is a complete package. That one here you are removed is just a part of holiness. You are put trousers away as a woman is just a part of it. That one is just more. From the Spanish, we say the dentro, the inside is what matters a lot. Be careful. Verse 7. To them who by patience continue in well doing, seek for glory and honor and immortality, eternal life. To them who by patience continue in well doing. Are you doing well? Please continue. Sister Adejoy, continue. You that sister, they're still doing good. Continue. There are people who don't want to hear to say, yeah, this person is suffering. Before they hear it, they are looking for what to do. That is the life of Christ. The Bible told us in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 16. Who is he that knoweth the mind of God, that he might instruct thee? But we have the mind of Christ. We have the mind of Jesus. The mind of Jesus will never allow to, he will never hear somebody suffering, and he will sleep and sleep well. How do you sleep well? When you hear a neighbor of you is outside, you hear your brother is sick in Africa, you have the money to take care of that your brother, you people have dubious mind. So Christians, I'm talking about Christians today. So Christians are so wicked. The other day I went to Ireland, I was in a car with a Hebrew friend, that day I just laughed. He said, man of God, and somebody just now just said they needed some money. I just quickly went, I said, yes, that is you are really God that really brought you my way. That day he just said it. Then somebody said he needed a home. I quickly went to go and sent the 250 euro. I said, God, if you had told me, I told him bullshit. I would not laugh. I would not ask him. I would have also said today would have been the day I would have revealed this matter to everybody. Praise Master Jesus. That is my life for you. That day I would have just laughed so that maybe before, as I'm going, the wife will give me envelope. I would just keep quiet. But I will expose him. The day we expose him. Today would be the day I will say that this man that they brought to Ireland, don't follow him. He's a stingy man. He will never give. But that is show to me what he did that day. And I pray, Lord, keep him that way in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I don't move with people. I don't move with stingy people. If you are stingy, I run from you. God, I know if also come to my, you will not also do for me. If you don't do it for that person, when you come to me, you will not also do it. So I don't move with people who are staging. People who their hand, set a gum, there's gum on it. Once it enter the pen, they pick it. It can never go away. But when you come to get from people, they know what to do. They are so crafty. They know what to say to get from others, but their own will never fall down. I will be watching. I will watch you. At 10 o'clock, I will run away from you. Praise Master Jesus. So if you have a friend who always wants to get from you, run away until you get your head. One day will take your head away from you. Such people will never be satisfied. They are looking for your head on the ground. As my brother said, I thought about it yesterday. Come for that. Last time I went to Ireland, I was saying, you, I love you, but I'll kill you. I love you so much, but I will destroy you. He said, God will save me from your harm. Praise Master Jesus. Brother, remember, he said, God will save you from your hand. So shall God save you from that friend's hand in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As any who always want to get from you, one day, they are targeting you. And some people, when the bank is dried up, they will run away. They are only loving you because you are still able to give now. They are still calling you. They are still with you because you are still able to give, but the day you cannot give anymore, just tell them, my brother, I don't have now. You see, the call will limit. The call they were calling you every day, tell them, I don't have anymore. You see, they will withdraw the call. Now, hey, my brother, how are you? God bless you. My sister, the next day, tell them you don't have again. That call will stop. And I pray the Lord deliver his children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible told us in Revelation chapter 21, verse 8, I'm talking about people who are illegal in hell, but they have permanent residence. Revelation 21, verse 8. But the fearful, you that are afraid of your husband now, because of my husband, because of my boss at work, I will not serve God. The unbelieving, are the abominable, are the murderers, and homogas, and sorcerers, and adulterers, and all liars, shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. For you not to be a recipient in hell, you better avoid it. Fear God more than every other man. Your husband, you have said, because of your husband, you will not serve God. You will divorce in one day. How? If you die, divorce have come. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
If you die tomorrow, that husband that said you will never leave, you will leave it. You must separate from your wife one day. So don't go to hell because of your husband. Don't go to hell because of your wife. Don't go to hell because of your boss. And if I did now, my boss with your boss will talk when you are talking about the most high boss, the boss of all boss. You are saying because of your boss at work, you will not do it, no problem. Both you and your boss will laugh in hell. It is laughter in hell. I pray God will open our eyes and our brain to know what to do at every given time in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The Bible told us in Revelation 20, verse 5, and whosoever was not found written in the book of life were cast into the lake of fire. Why will your name not found in the book of life? Why? Why? Your name must be there. Why will your name not be there? Because of your sin. Why will our name not be found there? Because of knowing what to do and doing it not. James 4, 17. I believe before any person sin, you must know that you want to sin. As my brother said today, our conscience must tell us, you want to sin, no? That place you are going to, God will not follow you there. Don't smoke. Don't drink alcohol. Don't say that word is a lie. That woman is not your wife. Don't sleep with her. That man is not your husband. Don't sleep with him. That man you are married to is not your husband. Leave that place now. You are still there. You are still there. Don't you see? You are the one carrying yourself to hell. Hell that Jesus Christ has dragged you away from. You want to go there. Why? Because of any pleasure. I pray the Lord will open our eyes now to see that thing in our life that is dragging us to hell, so that we will not become a recipient in a culture that was never for us. Children of God, hell was never meant for us. Hell was created out of anger in the heart of God. Because of what Satan did to him. God created hell for because of anger. And whenever God is angry, you know what he does? Before the anger are poured into hell, their smoke shall rise forever. Whenever God is angry, the anger is poured into hell. And the smoke will be rising every day, every day. Whenever sister sin, whenever I sin, why the reason why we are not dead instantly, whenever we are sin, we sin against God, there will be anger in his heart. What do you do? We pour the anger into hell. And we make the people here will shout again, and their smoke will rise. What makes smoke rise every day here is the anger of God that is pouring into hell. If you still enter there, it will pour it upon you. Whenever God just says, go to his father and say, Father, hey, yeah, my daughter Dupe have just sinned. Hey, my son Fred have just sinned. Please forgive. I died for him. I died for her. That pumping in the heart of God, that he would have, that wrath would have poured upon you, it will pour it into hellfire. And their smoke will rise again. You will hear all of them will shout again, hey! Hey! If you enter, you will shout the same shout. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. And I pray every one of us on this mountain,
hell will not absorb us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We know the Bible told us in Romans 6, verse 23, there's no other payment for hell. The Lord will not use heaven to pay you because of iniquity. You will not sin against God and he will pay you with righteousness. Unrighteousness is the use of unrighteousness to pay unrighteousness. If you die in your sin, you go to where sinners are found in hell. Romans 6, 23. For the wages of sin is dead, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Choose this day. Choose ye this day where you want to live eternal life. If you want to go to hell, it's well open for you. Wherever you want to be, it's open. The gate is not locked. If you want to make heaven, heaven is open for you to come in. And if you still want to go to hell, it's open. But it is my plea this morning. I'm begging myself this morning. I'm begging you this morning that don't go to hell. You will not enjoy it. There is no department in hell that people are laughing. It's not. There's no department in hell. And yet, so no smile in hell. Those who have been in hell for thousands of years, till today, they are not used to hell. You can never be used to hell. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Don't think maybe when I get there, after 3 days, I'll be used to it. It's renewed every day. The pain is new every day. And the demons will never be tired of piercing you if you find yourself there. And I pray that nobody on this mountain, out of busybody, out of selfishness, out of company, out of whatever, will not find ourselves in hell in the name of Jesus Christ. I fear God so much. After the fear of God, the next fear is hell. I will tell you. After the fear of God in me, the next year I fear someone in here, I don't fear any human being on earth. I don't fear human being. I respect people, but I will never fear man. But that place called hell, after the fear of God, I fear that place so much. Because I don't want to go there. I pray God will open our eyes, not the one they draw, not the one you see on draw or paper. Those ones are just nothing. I pray God will open your eyes to see it, to see what hell is all about. If God open your eye to see hell, if you see from this side, you will run away. The little one he has shown to me, just the little one I saw, I said, Father, I don't want to go there. And I pray, let's say, Father, show her to the husband. Have you shown her to you? If you show her to you, that little thing you are seeing, you will not see it. You will not see it. Hey, Lord Jesus, show my husband her. But you are angry with your mother-in-law for many years. You are not forgetting her. Hey, Father, my husband, show him her. But your husband, that same husband that you are saying is not good. Your husband will tell you, I want to give my mother money to buy provision to eat. You will tell your mother, you tell your husband that your mother is a witch. Which, when he was in primary school, he don't kill his child. He carried that child in the womb. He don't kill that child, a witch. That same witch, he trained the child in primary school. He don't kill the child, a witch. That same witch, he watched his son go to university. He did not kill his son, a witch. He watched his child to come to Europe. He did not kill the child, a witch. He watched his child to have a job. The child is working. He did not kill the child, a witch. But when he's not married, you are the witch. You have turned the mother into a witch. Now, you are the witch, woman. You are the witch, and as you are depriving that woman, that poor woman that went to farm to train the children from eating from their children, you will never eat the food
of your children. Oh, let me repeat. I don't know the pastor that told you that that woman is a witch. I don't know the prophet that told you that that woman is a witch. That was never a witch when he carried the child in the womb. There was never a witch when the child was suffering. When he will use a hand to remove catarrh from the nose of the child. When he will carry one load on her head and put the child in her hand, coming from the farm, that man now that you are now depriving the mother from eating from. The mother put a load of base of garri cassava in his head, in her head, and put the child with one wrapper in her back. And from back, we throw the breast to him in the back. To, woman, you are wicked. Woman, you are wicked. I don't know the revelation you saw that that woman became a witch now. You are the witch of that family. And the Lord will chase you away in the name of Jesus Christ. If the woman is a witch, let the Lord judge it. But allow the son to feed the mother. The day my wife will tell me, she will not even try it. She will not even try it. I want to say, don't even ask me how much. Let me do it. Because you were not there when she was training me. Don't ask me how much I'm saying to my mother. You don't try it. And will you also tell me, let us say to my mother, I will not deprive you from doing it. Because I know what she went through. Look at those little children now, somewhere different than salvation. See what my wife is going through in their hands. And this woman now will now train these children this way. At the end, they will now say they get married. And their wife is saying their mother is a witch. How will the mother feel? That is what your parents, your in-laws are feeling now as you are doing it to them. You will not enjoy your own home. For the past 4 years now, you have tied your husband down. He does not even remember the parents again. You are enjoying. You have built a house for your parents. Wonderful. You have tied your parents' road. Wonderful. But where he came from, they are languishing in poverty. They are languishing. Oh God, sir, I don't know how to preach this message again. That poor man is still going to the same farm he will be going to. And you have used that same your husband to pull your parents out of farm. All your lazy parents now do now is to fold their house every day. At the end of the month, you carry money and give to them. You, the Lord is warning you. I don't know who God is talking to right now. You, that sister, you better repent of that your evil. Or else, you will go to hell and burn to ashes. And that ashes will reform again. You will burn to ashes and reform again if you don't repent. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Whew. And the Bible says, for you and I not to go to hell. Whatever will make us to avoid hell, let us do it now. I'm closing that because of time. Mark 9:43. And if thy right hand offend thee, cut it off. If is that your character, and send it to hell, change your character. If it's stinginess, and send it to hell, don't stingin again. If it's lying, and send it to hell, don't lie again. Praise Master Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Mark 9:43. And if the right hand, according to sin, cut it off. If it is, it is better for thee to enter into life, maimed, than having two hands to go into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched. Christ speaking here. If it's that second house you are building that will take you to hell, stop building it and use the money to take care of your family people. Take care of people around you. If you spend money that you are not supposed to spend, the money I'm supposed to use to take care of blessing that God has sent to me, I'm not going to use it to buy another thing. That is struggle. That is the hand you cut off now. Cut it off. That your stingy hand. Cut it off.
And I pray the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. This is how I can go. I have a lot to say. But I said today, I'm not going to quote the Bible. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 Bible verses that I don't quote. But I'm not here to be quoted. They are not hearing. They will not read it when they get to. What does it mean? Let me say the one you will hear now. Maybe this one will touch you. We'll come again. My friend will come and quote the Bible again tomorrow morning. Amen. Amen. Stand up on your feet and say, Father, have mercy upon me. Wherever I was sending myself to hell, have mercy upon me. I repent today. Father, I get my own from inside. Maybe my own is stinginess. My own is lying. My own is sowing the seed of discord. My own is that I don't want to see other people rejoicing. I want to be happy, other people not to be happy. Say, Father, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Father, Lord, have mercy. Maybe I deprive your husband from doing what you do for the people. Say, Father, have mercy. And maybe you are a husband. You all only want your parents to be happy, but your parents, your wife parents, never to be happy. You are calling your wife parents rich, but your parents are enjoying you. Say, Father, have mercy. Lord, me. Touch my heart. Change my heart. Change my mind, O God. Help me walk on my heart that I might not go to hell. In Jesus' next name, we pray that prayer again.
Yes.
That's in the name of
Amen.
I want you to open your eyes, Father. Whatever super glue that the devil has poured on this hand, that whenever anything enter, it will just gone. Whenever I want to get it, it will open. When once it enter, it will gone. Never to open for any other person. Say, Father, use your blood to wash that super glue out of my hand. That aradite, Father, use your blood to wash it away. That when it enter, and you ask to give, I'll be able to give it out. In the name of Jesus Christ, open and pray.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, use your blood to wash my hands. Amen.
I want us to also pray whatever Satan has to cross our hearts, so people stand across. Tithe they will not pay, offering they will not give, help the poor they will not do, nothing they do. But those who want to make heaven, which heaven are you going to? I want to pray, Father, whatever Satan has to cross my heart, that your word does not have effect in my heart anymore. No matter they preach it, it's like they are pouring water on stone. Father, take that thing away from my heart and make it soft as your heart, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, pray.
Father,
Are you here? You're not born again. I don't need to speak too much. Just say this word after me. If you want to accept Christ, ask the Lord and personal Savior. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. I was on my way to hell, but your word has put me out now. Satan, I reject you from now on. You are a cheat. You are pushing to where I never belong to. I belong to heaven. Lord Jesus Christ, wash me clean. Take my name away from the book of death. And write it in the book of life. I announce today that Lord Jesus Christ be my Lord and personal Savior. I am born again today. All things have passed away and all things are from you. I go now to do what I'm supposed to do. In Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. Father, I thank you. I bless you. I worship you. Lord Jesus, you have spoken to me. Oh God, especially, you have spoken to every one of us on this mountain. Lord Jesus, we'll go now and start searching what is that thing I was supposed to do that I have not been doing. Father, the grace to do it to God. Father, before it's too late, give it to us, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, is there anyone we are supposed to help genuinely? They need help genuinely. But we are refraining them from enjoying what they would have enjoyed from us, O God. Father, help us, O God. Do touch that our heart, O God. And teach us to do the right thing. Because it's only the right thing of people to enter the right kingdom on the last day. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, have I spoken to God out of concept? But I have mercy upon you. Forgive me. Purge me. And help me to be the doer of the message I preach today. Help every minister on this mountain to be to show a good example to our followers. Also, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus, because I know no one on this mountain will be a prey to hell on the last day. In Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. Amen.